This is problem three on test one. And the problem says that there's a person who walks from here to here. I put the numbers for mine up here. 4.5 blocks west and 3.5 blocks north and then 8.5 blocks east. Several people didn't quite get the directions straight on this. You got to realize these are vectors. They go in a certain direction. You have to make west go west and north go north and east go east. So if you don't know the compass rose yet, drive it into your head, go find yourself a compass, you can surf the web, I think your phone even has one. Just figure out which way is north, west, east, and south. And actually, you don't even need to know which way it is in reality, just need to know that. Well, let me show you. North, west, east, and south. This is the compass rose. If you're facing north, west and east spell we. Starts with W and goes to E. Spells we. So, and then south is going to be the opposite of north. So this girl starts here, travels 4.5 blocks west, 3.5 blocks north, and then 8.25 blocks east. And it asks for three questions. The first question is the displacement, amount and direction, and then the distance traveled. This is a great question to drive home the point of a vector and displacement versus distance, which is just the amount, okay? So let's do the distance one first, because that's the easiest. The distance one says, well, it's just like if you had the odometer in on your car, you set it to zero here, and you walked 4.5 blocks this way, 3.5 blocks this way, and 8.5 blocks that, 8.25 blocks that way. So the distance is just 4.5 plus 3.5 plus 8.25. You just add them straight up. That's the distance. That's just straight. That's all you need to know, distance. Now, the other one's trickier. Displacement is a trickier question because displacement concerns itself with where did you start and where did you end? That's all it cares about. It doesn't care about how you got there. It just says you started here and you ended here. That's what this delta, you see that triangle there? That's what that means. That means final position minus initial position. It doesn't care about anything that happens between. Whereas this distance only cares about what happened in between. It doesn't care about where you ended up at all. So what we care about is this. This is delta x, and it's a vector. Notice it's got a certain length, that's the magnitude, and it's pointing crooked. It's not straight x or y. It's not straight sideways or straight up. It's crooked, and that's the direction part. So we gotta figure both of these things out. So to do this, we have to add up all of our x's and add up all of our y's. So let me add these up over here. So we're gonna add up our x's, okay? So you're gonna have negative 4.5 and positive 8.25. You see why this one's negative? Because it's going to the left. West is the left. It's going to the left, so that's negative. So when you add these together, that's going to give you your change in position in x. And notice it's going to be this amount here. Just that. Right, because this part is shared by the same amount, so it's just going to be this amount. So let's see, if it was 4.5, it would be 4 even, but this is 3.25, 3.75. Okay, so it's positive 3.75. Now I'm going to draw that up here in blue. So it's going to go from here to here. This is my net x, okay? And it's 3.75, and notice it's positive, okay? Now we're gonna add up our y's. Now for this particular problem, it's real easy, because you only have one y component. Everything else is horizontal. So I'm gonna draw that one in blue. So when we add up our y's, we're gonna have 3.5 plus nothing else, And that's going to give us 3.5. I can do that one in my head. So let's see. So I'm going to add that one here. This is my net y, and that's 3.5. Now to figure out how long is my vector, what is the magnitude of the displacement? Magnitude just means how much. How far did I walk? Let me try to say it a third way. How far displacement means what's the net change in position? I need to know this red side, but I figured out the two blue sides. Well, this is just a right triangle, because remember, x and y are always perpendicular to each other. So you're going to do a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So you use Pythagorean theorem. So now, when we're going to write this out on your paper, delta x, the vector is equal to 3.75 squared plus 3.5 squared square root. That's Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Solve it for c. Now that's the magnitude. That's the first thing that WebAssign is asking for. But we also need an angle here. And so we need to get this angle here. How do we get that angle? Well, we now have all three sides. We have this side and this side, and for that matter, you just figured out this side. So you can use sine, cosine, or tangent, whatever floats your boat. I don't care. I'm going to use tangent here because I have those written on the board. So to get theta, I'm going to say tangent of theta is opposite over adjacent. So it's going to be 3.5 over 3.75. So then theta is equal to the arctangent of 3.5 over 3.75. Okay? So you might ask, well, where'd you put the points on this? Okay, so here's where I got the points. First of all, I gave you a quarter point for drawing the picture. Second of all, I gave you half a point if you split it into x's and y's. Then I gave you a quarter point if you added your x's properly. I didn't put any points on adding the y's properly because, you know, there's only one thing there. And then I gave you half a point for knowing how to use Pythagorean theorem and half a point for knowing how to figure out the angle. So let me finish writing this, I forgot. Delta x vector is the amount and the angle. So if you're writing on your paper, you have to write it out this way. WebAssign just asks for this number and then it asks for that number separately. And I also gave you one point for adding these up properly. Now, a fair number of y'all missed this one, but it's a pretty straightforward problem, so I hope that y'all go through this and figure out where you made your mistake and how to do it properly. So, moving on to the next problem now.